Hi, I'm Gabby Hanna with William Ravis Real Estate. In these dramatic times, are you thinking about the quality of your life and where you live it? I'm here to help. Call 917-696-8952. We can have a Zoom chat and find out how I can help you live your dream. 5% of any closed sale will be donated to the Provincetown Theater.
Serving eclectic and delicious meals at your community year-round waterfront restaurant, Finizzi's is a longtime supporter of the arts on Cape Cod and beyond. So when the time is right, come take a seaside seat at Finizzi's.
Budget Blinds Mid and Outer Cape Cod is proud to support the community we serve. Remember, we design, we measure, we install, you enjoy.
Hello, Scott Allegretti here. Congratulations to everyone at the Provincetown Theater for an amazing renaissance. Please consider giving back to the arts community and please stay healthy and strong. Thank you.
When visiting the Outer Cape, the Lobster Pot is a Provincetown tradition you will not want to miss. Enjoy a beautiful harbor view meal in one of our two waterfront dining rooms, starting daily at 11:30 a.m., offering the finest and freshest in seafood, Portuguese specialties, steaks, poultry, vegetarian, light fare, and of course, our award-winning clam chowder. The entire menu is also available for takeout. Or just pop in at the top of the pot bar for one of our famous Bloody Marys or other signature drinks. The Lobster Pot, family owned and operated for 41 years. We're all working differently for now. But for all of us at Siemens Bank, we continue to be inspired by our experience with so many local businesses and families whose hard work and commitment to each other and to the community show the way to getting through this together.
When looking to visit Provincetown, look no further than the Somerset House Inn. With charming modern lodgings in the ideal Provincetown location, the Somerset House Inn is situated on Commercial Street just across from the Cape Cod Bay. Within walking distance to shops, art galleries, restaurants, and the beach, the Somerset House Inn is open year-round.
Advertising support for our season includes Kindling Grover Real Estate, The Boat Slip, Burns & Levinson, Joe DiMartino at Coldwell Banker, Pat Schultz Real Estate, the Lexvist Group, including the Cape Cod Inn, Breakwater Hotel, and Truro Cottages, the Adam Peck Gallery, Emily Flax at Atlantic Bay Sotheby's, Relish Bakery and Sandwich Shop, Tim Brown at Seascape Realty, Victor's Restaurant,
Lisa Bergeron at William Ravis Real Estate,
Test and Treat, Blue Day Spa, Joel Harms at William Ravis Real Estate, P-Town Hacks, Cape Air, and the Strangers and Saints Restaurant, plus the major support of the Arts Foundation of Cape Cod, Broadway Cares, Equity Fights AIDS, the Cape Cod Five Foundation, the David Adams Schoolman Trust, the Eastman Bank Charitable Foundation, Mass Humanities, the Paulette Fund, the Provincetown Tourism Fund, the Roy Cockrum Foundation, the Theater Community Benevolent Fund, and of course, donations from audiences like you.
It's not the glow you feel when snow appears. It's not the Christmas card you've sent for years. Not the joyful sound when sleigh bells ring, or the merry songs children sing. The little gift you give on Christmas Day will not bring back the friend you've turned away. So may I suggest the secret of Christmas is not the things you do at Christmas time, but the Christmas things you do
Season's greetings to one and all. My name is David Wilson, and I'm the president of the Board of Directors of the Provincetown Theater. Welcome to our annual Townie Holiday Show, and thank you for tuning in. This is a moment where we come together as a community to find hope, humor, faith, and joy in and for each other. We share holiday songs, we tell goofy stories, hopefully that makes all of us laugh, because we certainly need it this year. The challenges our community has endured in 2020 is beyond anything we would have experienced. On behalf of our board, staff, sponsors, donors, and patrons, thank you for helping us get through this difficult year. We shifted all of our live productions to an online platform, and you transitioned with us. Thank you for taking this virtual journey with us. Your donations have kept us alive these past 10 months. In keeping with our past tradition, we've never set a ticket price for the Townie Holiday Show. Rather, we've suggested a donation of $20. So please consider a donation tonight. As I look at the time, Tawny Heatherton should be here, but I think she's late. Despite the start of a snowy winter, Tawny promised me she'd be here with bells on. So please keep an ear and an eye open, because Tawny will certainly be here shortly, jingling down the road with bells on. Until then, sit back, relax, and enjoy the 24 acts that we've lined up from our community. Let the show begin. Happy holidays.
Hello, it's Zoe Lewis. And I wish you a Merry Christmas. I wish you a Merry Kwanzaa. I wish you a Merry Hanukkah and a Happy New Year. I wish you a Merry everything. And most of all, my beautiful P-Towners, I wish that 2021 will see the opening of the theatre, of all the performance spaces in town, and we can have our arts back. Because I love you all, and arts are good for the heart. Have a beautiful time. Cheers, everyone. Happy New Year.
Happy holidays, everybody, from East End Books, P-Town.
Happy holidays from Loveland.
Hi, this is Gaston at Studio Lacombe. Happy holidays, everyone.
Hey, everyone. It's Paige Turner from New York City. I perform every year at the Pilgrim House in Provincetown. And I just want to say happy holidays to everyone. And thank you for tuning in to the Townie Holiday Extravaganza. And you know, Provincetown is a magical place. And no matter what time of year it is, or no matter what's going on. So I hope that you are having a wonderful, wonderful holiday season, and 2021 is going to be amazing. I can't wait to go back to P-Town and see all of you. Happy holidays, happy new year, everybody. Spread the love, spread the joy.
Another holiday without you, Mom. Miss you. This one's for you. Oh, there's no place like home for the holidays. 'Cause no matter how far away you roam, when you pine for the sunshine of a friendly gaze, for the holidays you can't beat home, sweet home. I met a man who lives in Tennessee, and he was heading for Pennsylvania and some homemade pumpkin pie. From Pennsylvania, folks are traveling down to Dixie's sunny shore. From Atlantic to Pacific, gee, the traffic is terrific. Oh, there's no place like home for the holidays. 'Cause no matter how far away you roam, if you wanna be happy in a million ways, for the holidays you can't beat home, sweet home. This is our favorite part, remember, Ma? I met a man who lives in Tennessee, and he was heading for Pennsylvania and some homemade pumpkin pie. From Pennsylvania, folks are traveling down to Dixie's sunny shore. From Atlantic to Pacific, gee, the traffic is terrific. Oh, there's no place like home for the holidays. 'Cause no matter how far away you roam, if you wanna be happy in a million ways, for the holidays you can't beat home, sweet home. For the holidays, you can't beat home, sweet home. Happy holidays. Merry Christmas.
Choose
a day when you're prepared to dream me. I'll be a good man, I swear. You'll see how much I care when you need me. You thrill me, you delight me. You please me, you excite me. You're all that I've been yearning for. I love you, I adore you. I lay my life before you. I only want you more and more. And finally it seems my lonely days are through. I've been waiting for you.
Kevin Hume from the Kevin Hume Show, and I'm here to tell a story about a spider from West Africa by the name of Anansi, who finds his way into Jamaica and become a Jamaican folklore. Now, Brother Anansi was always cooking at his house, and the title of the story is Why Dogs Ate Cats. Now, one day Brother Anansi was cooking at his house. It was a hot, sunny day, and Brother Cat and Brother Dog decided to go by Brother Anansi's house for lunch. Now, Brother Cat and Brother Dog went over by Brother Anansi, and the house was smelling so nice. It was like smelling with all the flavors bursting out of the porridge. So Brother Anansi said, "Oh, Brother Cat and Brother Dog, I'm happy you're here. I'm cooking porridge and I'm going to offer you some." So Brother Anansi is very conniving. He decides, "Listen, I am going to make a joke. I'm going to make a fun of these guys." So he decided, "Listen, I am going to have a drinking contest. A porridge drinking contest." So the Brother Cat and Brother Dog was like, yeah. So I said, "Who can drink porridge the fastest?" Brother Dog said, "Oh, I can drink porridge fast. Brother Cat said, me, I'm the fastest. Nobody can test me." Brother Anansi was so happy, you know, he was like, "Yes, I find the right guys." So he said, "You know what? At 12 o'clock at the dark, this porridge contest is gonna start." So he tell all the other people, all the other animals around, they gather around to Brother Anansi's house. Brother Anansi pulled Brother Cat aside and said, "Brother Cat, I want you to tell Brother Dog that you're going to put your porridge in the hot sun." And he went and told Brother Dog, "Brother Dog, I want you to tell Brother Cat, you're going to put your porridge on the fire." So Brother Cat said, "Yeah, that's a good idea." So Brother Cat went to Brother Dog and said, "Brother Dog, I am going to put my porridge in the hot boiling sun. That's the way I like it." But that dog was like, "Oh yeah, I know the sun is going to make that porridge so hot." So he was so happy he's going to win. So he said, "You know what, Brother Dog, Brother Cat, I am going to put my porridge on the stove and I'm just going to turn it down a little bit." So at the time, at the contest, 12 o'clock comes around, all the animals get up and everybody was ready for this contest. So Brother Anansi bring the porridge out. Brother Cat porridge, Brother Dog porridge. So I say, "Honey Mark, get set, go!" Brother Cat running, man, and Brother Cat start drinking, and was so everybody was like cheering Brother Cat on, and Brother Dog, every time he dip his mouth in the porridge, he was like, ho. The porridge was so hot, it was burning Brother Dog, and Brother Dog could not drink the porridge. Brother Cat finished, and he was laughing, and everybody was laughing at Brother Dog. Brother Dog gets so mad, he start chasing at Brother Cat. And he chased Brother Cat round and round and up the tree and all of it. And Brother Anansi was rolling and dancing and laughing. And from that day till now, the cat and the dog was always at hand. And the dog was always chasing the cat. And that's the end of the story. Merry Christmas and have a happy new year. From the Kevin Hume Show and Aziza Hume.
Oh come Emmanuel, Merry Christmas! Happy New Year's with Peck and Bull Leather!
This is Mick, doing in leather. Merry Christmas!
Happy Holidays from Scott Cakes!
Happy Holidays from Spirit Pizza!
Happy Holiday from Greg Salvatore!
Good evening, everyone. And here's to the returning light. If, like me, you find holidays challenging, and this one particularly so, I thought this tune by Dori Previn, one of my favorite singer-songwriters, might be appropriate. I was driving in my car, screaming at the night, screaming at the dark, screaming at fright. I wasn't doing nothing, just driving around, screaming at the dark, letting it out, That's all that I was doing. Just letting it out. Well, along comes a motorcycle, very much to my surprise. I said, "Officer, was I speeding?" I couldn't see his eyes. He said, "No, you weren't speeding." And he felt where his gun was hung. He said, "Mister, you're screaming at the top of your lungs. And you were doing it alone, you were doing it alone. You were screaming in your car in a 20-mile zone. You were doing it alone, screaming. You were doing it alone, you were doing it alone. You were screaming in your car in a 20-mile zone. You were doing it alone, screaming." I said, "I'll roll up all my windows. Don't want to disturb the peace. I'm just a creature who's looking for a little release." I said, "And what's so wrong with screaming? Don't you do it at your games? When the quarterback breaks an elbow, when the boxer beats and maims. But you were doing it alone, you were doing it alone. You were screaming in your car in a 20-mile zone. Doing it alone, screaming. You were doing it alone, you were doing it alone. You were screaming in your car in a 20-mile zone. You were doing it alone, screaming." I said, "Animals roar when they feel like, so why can't we do that too? Instead of screaming bonsai baby in the war in the human zoo." He said, "I got to take you in now, follow me right behind, and let's have no more screaming like you're out of your mind." And he climbed aboard his cycle, and his red-eyed headlight beamed, and his motor started spinning, and his siren screamed. He was doing it alone, screaming on his bike in a 20-mile zone. He was doing it alone, screaming. I was doing it alone, I was doing it alone. I was screaming in my car in a 20-mile zone. Doing it alone, screaming. We were doing it together, we were doing it together. We were screaming at the dark in a 20-mile zone. We were doing it together, screaming. We were doing it together, we were doing it together. We were doing it together, we were doing it together. We were doing it together, we were doing it together. We were doing it together, we were doing it together. Alone in a 20-mile zone.
Hanukkah pairings. Jelly-filled sufganiyot. Applesauce latkes. Chocolate gelt melts on tongue savoring sweetness. Small gifts to unwrap. Bet 18 pennies, spin your dreidel, claim the pot. Gimel wins the lot. Don't just spin dreidels. A call to all Maccabees when tyrants rise up. Ancient menorahs, said to have burned for 8 days, have been back ordered. Hanukkah tonight, colored candles burning bright, we still fight the fight. With songs and blessings, a rainbow of proud colors can light up the night. A great miracle. Where did it happen and when? Why not here and now? May the lights of Hanukkah continue to burn bright during the coming year. Happy holidays.
Happy holidays from all of us at Phoenicians.
Hello, Province Townies. We who have relocated to St. Petersburg, Florida, made you a postcard because we miss you. We tried many different renditions of songs, but we ultimately came up with one that was a Christmas postcard for you. We tried, "We miss you and Merry Christmas, we miss you and Merry Christmas, we miss you and Merry Christmas. Hope to see you next year," but that wasn't quite it. So we've tried some others, and eventually you'll see all of us on the postcard.
Dashing on the beach with a bucket in our hands. Provincetown, so far from reach, we miss your fine wetlands. The snow will soon be there, and everyone in Uggs. Provincetown, we send you love, you know how much we care. Oh, Provincetown, Provincetown, clear and bright and gay. Out on the tip of old Cape Cod, we miss you every day. Hey, Provincetown, Provincetown, queer and bright and gay. Out on the tip of old Cape Cod, we miss you every day. We miss Commercial Street, where gays and lesbians play. We have Central Ave and Sun. This town is also gay. Oh, Provincetown, Provincetown, queer and bright and gay. Out on the tip of Old Cape Cod, we miss you every day. Mwah.
Mwah. Merry Love Christmas. You. We miss Happy you. Happy Hanukkah. Happy holidays.
Oh, Provincetown, we send you Christmas greetings. From Florida, yes, Florida, it simply bears repeating. We miss Commercial Street, it's true, but now our toes are turning blue. Oh, Provincetown, we send you Christmas greetings. May remember some of us, we used to be your neighbors. We loved to see as salty air, as drag we do with purple hair. We loved your plays and our shows too, and gossip whispered about you. Oh, Provincetown, we send you Christmas greetings. Oh, Provincetown, we wonder how you're doing. And so we ask without regret, are all the tourists gone yet? We miss you all, it's not that to say, but now we're in Saint-Pete's estate. Oh, Provincetown, send our love and greetings.
That's probably good.
We got a chafing dish from Marty, an itchy scarf from Uncle Paul. Every year we are left with tchotchkes that
can I do with kitchen witches, bargains from craft fairs and the mall? I dread the holidays all through the fall.
Rewrap, re-gift, rewrap, re-gift, that's how we must cope. Problems transformed into solutions, depression turning into hope. Rewrap, re-gift, rewrap, re-gift, our brand of fair trade. No shame in using your resources, turn lemons into lemonade. For Cousin Rachel, two sets of fondue forks for salt.
Give him the paperweight and ashtray. Give him the shawl.
Molly might like the driftwood necklace.
She would prefer the macrame.
It's so much better to pass on than pay. Rewrap, re-gift, rewrap, re-gift. Who needs a receipt? Each Trojan horse in shiny paper.
I'd like to read a little poem by a wonderful English poet named Thomas Robertson, also known as Tom Foolery. It's a sort of bedtime story about 2020 and what might happen on the other side. The name of the poem is The Great Realization.
Tell me one about the virus, then I'll go to bed.
But my boy, you're growing weary, sleepy thoughts about your head.
That one's my favorite. Please, I promise, just once more.
Okay. Snuggle down, my boy. But I know you all too well. This story starts before then, in a world I once would dwell. It was a world of waste and wonder, of poverty and plenty, back before we understood why hindsight's 2020. You see, the people came up with companies to trade across all lands, but they swelled and got much bigger than we ever could have planned. We'd always had our wants, but now it got so quick. You could have anything you dreamed of in a day, and with a click. We noticed families had stopped talking. That's not to say they never spoke, but the meaning must have melted and the work-life balance broke. And the children's eyes grew squarer, and every toddler had a phone. They filtered out the imperfections, but amidst the noise, they felt alone. And every day the skies grew thicker till you couldn't see the stars, so we flew in planes to find them while down below we filled our cars. We drove around all day in circles. We'd forgotten how to run. We swapped the grass for tarmac, shrunk the parks till there were none. And we filled the sea with plastic because our waste was never capped. Until each day when you'd go fishing, you'd pull them out already wrapped. And while we drank and smoked and gambled, our leaders taught us why it's best to not upset the lobbies. More convenient to die. But then, in 2020, a new virus came our way. The governments reacted and told us all to hide away. But while we were all hidden amidst the fear and all the while, the people dusted off their instincts. They remembered how to smile. They started clapping to say thank you and calling up their mums. And while the car keys gathered dust, they would look forward to their runs. And with the skies less full of voyagers, the earth began to breathe. And the beaches bore new wildlife that scuttled off into the seas. Some people started dancing, some were singing, some were baking. We'd grown so used to bad news, but some good news was in the making. And so, when we found the cure and were allowed to go outside, we all preferred the world we'd found to the one we'd left behind. Old habits became extinct, and they made way for the new, and every simple act of kindness was now given its due.
But why did it take a virus to bring the people back together?
Well, sometimes you've got to get sick, my boy, before you start feeling better. And now, close your eyes and dream of tomorrow and all the things that we can do. And who knows, if you dream hard enough, maybe some of them will come true. We now call it the Great Realization. And yes, since then there have been many. But that's the story of how it started and why hindsight's 2020.
Здравейте, приятели от близо и далеч! Казвам се Елена Манчева и ще ви поздравя с една коледна песен от България. Благодаря на Джон Томас и Дейвид Грей за поканата и за техния безкрайен ентузиазъм, с който представят и почитат музика от целия свят. В песента, която ще ви спея, се разказва за малка мома, която приготвя дома си да посрещне добри гости коледари. А коледарите са група от млади мъже и ергени, водени от по-възрастен женен мъж, които обикалят от къща на къща на тъдни вечер. Те благославят и пеят за доброто на всеки един член от семейство. В знак на благодарност, стопаните ги даряват с колации и сушени. Jane Hoover. Malka moma dvorime te oj koledo, moj koledo, dvorime te stoli redi, oj koledo, moj koledo, na Malka moma, oj koledo, moj koledo, daj dojdat dobri gosti, oj koledo, moj koledo, dobri gosti,
Koleda. Merry Christmas from the Monument Barbershop.
Happy holidays from Lemon Crafts.
Reindeer and singing songs of joy and peace.
I wish I had a river I could skate away
Amazing. I love Trish LaRose, and you know, we were so gifted to have her sing for us this year, last year, and of course in our production of Sweeney Todd. All these performers tonight, amazing, giving, 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 and we cannot wait to open our doors again so that we can have them back on our stage. And speaking of that, there's gonna be about a dozen more performers coming up, including the kids from the Provincetown school system, thanks to Megan Amores, who has built us. They're gonna be coming up very soon after this break. And Tawny Heatherton, if she ever gets here, she's on her way. We're hoping that that's gonna really happen. What makes it happen though for all of us is you. You've shown up all year for us and you're gonna show up for us. I know in 2021 when we get productions back on, when it's safe to do so, we have a lot of plans coming up for you, as well as continuing our virtual programming. But to do so, we need your help, we need your support, we need your donations. It's your theater, it's your community, and we want to have your community theater here available to us all next year. So without further ado, I hope you will enjoy the rest of the Towny Holiday Extravaganza.
Happy holidays and
Vesela
Koleda from Wife Puppy.
We weren't so freaking strange. They made us feel that way, but it's they who need to change.
The way they think, that is.
That's right, Silas.
Let your freak flag fly.
My what?
Let your freak flag fly. Never take it down, never take it down. Raise it way up high. Let your freak flag fly. Let it fly, fly, fly.
It's hard being a puppet. So many strings attached. But it's not a choice you made. It's just how you were hacked.
Hi, my name is Tamora Israel. I'm a poet, performer, and voiceover artist. I'm so excited to be a part of the Towny Holiday Extravaganza. I'm going to read for you a poem I wrote called Capes. When I was a kid, the idea of the year 2020 sounded bright, like constant alien light hovering over us. There would be flying cars, of course, bionic arms, smell-o-vision would finally be a thing, and superheroes would just walk amongst us. The future was going to be unprecedented. Well, here we are on the tail end of 2020, and wow! This has been a year for the history books, plural, stories playing out through street art murals, laying out the blueprints, but have yet to learn from past events. Let's figure out how this madness got past the fence. We thought we were armed to the teeth, but somehow facts have found themselves aligned with deceit. Another one bites the dust. Lions and sheep, 2020 is the kind of bright that'll blind you to sleep. Anger and rage over continued injustice poured out into the streets. People are taking a stand in an effort to claim a seat. Defense wins games, and don't be afraid to tread water in the deep end for change. Ruth Bader Ginsburg taught us that women belong in all places where decisions are being made. Chadwick Boseman taught us that the difference between a hero and a villain is that the villain uses that power in a way that is selfish and hurts other people. Let's be the heroes of our own stories. Let's spread love and compassion, teach with patience. It won't always be receptive, but at least you know that the good inside of you was present. Leave the kind of impact on the world that you wish you had on the days where it is hardest to be a human. As we drag our tattered and bandaged bodies over what has to be the longest fever dream, I pray that we do so with an understanding that kindness is easy, different is good, and love is love. My dear friends, a toast to us. May 2021 be boring as hell. Good luck. Much love.
Sun breaking on the seawater, washing over me, moving with the sound of angels. Holy Trinity, tangles of light in your hair. In the snow I see you there, season to season. What I love best is sailing home to you and me. Home to you and me. Oh,
Happy holidays from Tinscapes.
Happy holidays from Karen's Candy.
Happy holidays from the coffee pot.
Happy holidays from Eddie at Essentials 2.
Happy holidays from Ruthie's.
Hello, season's greetings from all of us here at Seize the Cape.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, our troubles will be miles away. Golden days of your heart.
Happy holidays from James Frederick at Perfect Studio Provincetown.
Happy holidays from Ikashi!
Good evening and happy holidays from Shank Painter Heights, Provincetown. The Jewish people are often referred to as the people of the book, which refers, of course, to the Bible. It also refers to the fact that Jews, historically, have always been people of words, as writers, publishers, and perhaps most of all, collectors of books. I've always loved reading and collecting books, among them a substantial collection of classic Yiddish short stories from such luminaries as Shalom Aleichem, I.L. Peretz, and Isaac Bashevis Singer. Hanukkah appears in many of these stories, so I thought to share one with you. But as I read through them, I realized, as is the case with many Yiddish stories, it's filled with in-jokes that would require too much explanation. Honestly, most of them are also just too long, short being very much a relative term in Yiddish short stories. So instead, I turned to a more modern library, the internet, and found a perfect collection of Jewish short stories on the theme of Hanukkah for the modern era, from perhaps the quintessential Bible of American Jewish East Coast life, The New Yorker magazine. Enjoy. The Last Maccabee by Yoni Brenner. Hear me, O God, he shouted, raising his broad bronze sword. Though you may test me, my sorrow shall be a grindstone, my suffering shall be a crucible, and I will not rest until this sacrificed land is delivered into the hands of the righteous. He beat his chest and let out a piercing war cry that struck fear into the hearts of his enemies. 5 minutes later, he was escorted out of the building by security, and although no one pressed charges, Kyle Maccabee would never work at Deloitte & Touche again. The Visitor by Yoni Brenner. On a bitterly cold night, on the outskirts of Vikovich, Velvel the tailor and Grunum the milkman were playing a friendly game of dreidel when they heard a knock at the door. Surprised, Velvel opened the door to find an old man with a long gray beard shivering in the darkness. Quickly, Velvel brought him into the fire and served him barley soup. When the color returned to the old man's face, he noticed the others were playing dreidel and asked if he might join them. What followed was the greatest exhibition of dreidel that two men, or any men, had ever seen. In less than an hour, the old man had parlayed 12 kopecks into 60 rubles, until the companions had nothing left to gamble. Astonished, Velvel asked how it was possible for a man to have such luck. My friends, the old man replied, it is not luck, for I am the prophet Elijah, come to reward your generosity with innumerable heavenly blessings. The men rejoiced, and they kissed Elijah's hands and his cheeks. The prophet blessed them, and he blessed their houses and their animals, but somehow he neglected to give back the 60 rubles. In the course of the holiday, Elijah would repeat the scam 23 times. The Judgment of Velvel by Yoni Brenner. Standing at the gates of Eden, Velvel the tailor watched with apprehension as the angel weighed his sins and virtues upon the scales of justice. And although Velvel had been honest in his business dealings and had recited the Shema every night, his penny pinching, along with his habit of stuffing his neighbor's mezuzahs with scrolls of prosciutto, had tipped the balance against them. Just as the angel was about to cast him below, Velvel remembered the night when Elijah had come to his house in the guise of an old man and fleeced him a dreidel. And so, hearing the tale, the angel called on Elijah, and Elijah appeared before them. It is true, Elijah said, corroborating the story. It was a cold night, and Velvel showed me great hospitality. Then Elijah mounted the scales of justice and tipped the balance towards righteousness. Suddenly, a 20-man SWAT team appeared and surrounded Elijah. Within seconds, the prophet was under arrest, charged with 89 counts of fraud. The angel shook Velvel's hand. Thanks for your cooperation, he said. We've been trying to nail this guy for years. Glad to help, Velvel said, removing his wire. Now, how do I get back to Earth? The angel shifted awkwardly and said, well, you're still dead. Happy holidays.
I used to have holly and ivy, kiss underneath the mistletoe, sing carols, drink barrels, wear festive apparels, but all that seems so long ago. I used to have turkey and stuffing, hang stockings up for St. Nick, but since I took a fancy to a girl from Delancey, my Yuletide has changed quite a bit. Now it's Peking duck for Christmas. by Shane, Amidal, and me. I had shepherds, three kings, and a manger. My nativity scene was the biz. But as soon as I saw her, I bought a menorah, and I learned that it is what it is. It seems that my cattle stopped lowing. My jingle bells all have been rung. But I'm happy as a clam in the house of Hunan, 'cause I'm here with my chosen one. Yes, it's Peking duck for Christmas. Then a movie we'll see. Oh, how can this guy not quartz with joy? My Shane, Amadal, and me. Sing along. It's Peking duck for Christmas. Lo mein and dumplings and tea. 'Tis the season of joy for my guy.
This song was written by Tom Waits. It's called Shiver Me Timbers.
Well, I'm leaving my family, I'm leaving my friends. My feet on the ground, but my heart's in. And these clouds, they're like headlines on a new front page sky. My tears are salt water, and the moon is riding high. And oh, Martin Eden is gonna be so proud of me. Called to the sea to be up in the crow's nest, singing their say, shiver me timbers, 'cause I'm a sailing.
on. And holiday greetings to you from Richfield, Minnesota, where butter is a spice and gravy is a beverage, to you in P-Town. I'm Miss Richfield 1981, and I'm so tickled to get a chance to say hello, and I'm really feeling the joy this holiday season. Ugh, it's more important than ever, right? And I wanted to mostly do this to say thank you, because it's been a crazy year. In fact, I'm losing my voice because I've been busy. I've been online, I've been doing a ton of stuff. And so it's actually been a good year of busyness. It hasn't been a great money year, I don't think, for any of us. But it has been busy of late. But you know, all of my computer stuff, which has gone really well this year, and hopefully you've joined me off and on for bingo and my holiday show and so forth. But that hasn't been the highlight. No. You know what the highlight's been? You. You were the highlight in P-Town because you allowed us to come in. Some of you, I know, didn't want that, but you bared with us. You put up with us, and just a handful of us got to do live shows, and that was the highlight of the whole year. And I just want to say thank you, whether you disagreed with it and whether you fought it, but thank you for just putting up with us and letting us do that. And I hope that last I saw, things seemed to be healthy there, and I hope that they still are. My heart is going out to you. And I wanted to sing a song for you, which will be coming from my heart, not my throat, by the way, because I have like no voice, but I'm going to do it anyway, because you're that important to me. And it's a song. I was thinking about 2020, because you know, there's so many holidays. So it's Christmas and Hanukkah and Kwanzaa and solstice and the Ramadan usually falls somewhere. I mean, there's so many holidays, so many different holidays. How do you do a song? How do you pick out a song, right? And so then I thought of the year 2020, and I thought of, you know, it's really been, well, quite frankly, a turd in the punch bowl. Yeah, it has been I think that would describe it real well. Turd in the punch bowl. Yeah. And that's just the way it's been. It's been a tough year. And so this song sustained me for these last few weeks. Yes. Because I thought, can I make it through these last few? And I thought, yes, I can make it through these last couple weeks. And so this is what has sustained me. And I hope you enjoy it. Goodbye, 2020. Better things ahead. Happy holidays, everyone.
Well, hello.
Stephen Green.
It's Handsome Ned. A.
B.
C.
D.
E.
E.
G.
H.
L.
J.
O.
Q.
Yeah, we're missing P-Town. And the rest of the alphabet. We will see you when the world opens up again. Until then, stay safe, friends, and relatively sane.
From Perry's in Provincetown, happy holidays!
Happy holidays from Marine Specialties. Happy holidays, y'all, from Tom Sharp.
finally made it through this winter snowstorm. Welcome to the Tawny Holiday Extravaganza. My shoes. Oh, and a new costume. Ta-da! This one. Now, I prepared a little song for you, and I brought my own music. But first, I have a little something I want to say before I sing this song for you. You know, I'm a wash ashore here, like a lot of people here in Provincetown, and I'm really grateful for this place that embraced me. I washed ashore like a shell or a bottle or a body, and they just brought me right into the fold. And that's the way it has been all through this whole pandemic up here. Everyone's been looking out for each other and helping each other. They've also been, everyone's been wearing the masks. We wore masks all summer. We didn't have all these cases. We've only had one fatality, thank God. And God bless John, who worked at Farland. God bless you. We took care of each other, and we're going to take care of each other as we go into 2021. Because that's the kind of community we belong to. And that's who I belong to. I belong to you, and you belong to me. And with that, I'd like to sing you a little song that has given me a lot of serenity and solace and cheer here during this year. Sunshine, lollipops, and rainbows. Everything that's wonderful is what I feel when we're together. Brighter than a lucky penny. You, when you're near, the rain clouds disappear, and I am fine. Just to know that you are mine. My life is sunshine, lollipops, and rainbows. That's how this refrain goes. Oh, come on, join in. Everybody, sunshine, lollipops, and rainbows. Everything that's wonderful is what is gonna be when you are in Provincetown like me. Sunshine, lollipops, and rainbows. Everything that's wonderful is what I feel when we're together. A brighter than a shining penny. When you're near, the rain clouds disappear, and you are fine. Just to know that you are mine. My life is sunshine, lollipops, and rainbows. Everything, that's how this refrain goes. So come join in and sing, everybody. Sunshine, lollipops, rainbows, everything that's wonderful is what it's gonna be. Cause you're in Provincetown, you come to Provincetown, you're in Provincetown like me. So come join us this summer for a day or a week, or just come. Thanks, Happy New Year.
Hi, Provincetown. I miss you. I can't wait until we can all hug each other again in the lobby of the theater. But until then, stay safe. Take care of yourselves, take care of each other. Till very soon.
Walking along the road, and I asked her, "Tell me, where are you going?" This she told me. Said, "I'm going down to Yaska's farm, gonna join in a rock and roll band. Got to get back to the land that set my soul free. We are stars. can I walk beside you? I have come here to lose the smog, and I feel as if a cog in something turning. Yes, and maybe it's the time of year, or maybe it's the time of man, but I don't know who I am. But life is for learning. We are stardust, we are golden, and we've got to get ourselves back to the garden. By the time we got to Woodstock, we were half a million strong. Garden.
Ooh. Oh Lord, it's been a year with little joys and little fears. It's finally here, Christmas Day. My love, I need some hope, a little faith, a hand to hold. It's awfully cold, Christmas Day.
Watch the snow fall down like me sometimes. But you pick me up and then pick me up again. Like the winter leaves, I can't survive without your light. Thank you for your smile. It's warmer than the fire. Your gentle laughter is sweeter than a choir. I'll never know the right words to choose. So all I can say, thank you.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace. Silent night, holy night, share shepherds quake at the sight. Glory stream from heaven afar. Heavenly hosts sing alleluia. Christ the Savior is born. Christ the Savior is born. Silent night, holy night, Son of God, saw the light, radiant beams from thy holy grace. With the dawn of redeeming grace, Jesus, Lord, at thy birth,